I think breakups are interesting, though, because sometimes there people approach it differently. There are people that totally just, you know, quadrant themselves off and go somewhere where they just stay in solitude for a while to work through it. Some people go and find their support group or their tribe to get through it. Some people jump to another relationship right away. Everyone has very different reactions to it. And then some people are very contemplative. Some people are blaming themselves for it. And I think, you know, the right mix is all of those things in a way, because I think you have to give yourself grace when you go through a breakup. So you're going to feel a lot of different emotions. You're going to feel lost. That's normal. But I think the main thing is allowing yourself to feel. I think there's just this desire sometimes when things hurt to numb out or not deal with it. But it also, it always has a way of circling back to you and catching up.
Yeah, it really does. It's kind of a case of deal with it now or deal with it later.
Yes. And I, you know, I use myself as a guinea pig. Like this is not related to like a breakup per se, but I lost my dad, you know, several months ago in June. And I also lost my mom within the last 18 months. And there were times it would have been easier to just numb out those feelings because and say, look, I don't really have time to like grieve, which sounds weird to people, but sometimes grief we know is going to take us to a place where we're disconnected and we feel very sad and we're emotional and it's unpredictable. So for people who really want to control outcomes, it's hard sometimes to relinquish to that. But what I found is like I had to just allow myself to feel what I feel. So there could be moments where I do cry or I am upset about it, or it could be a moment of joy when I remember something, you know, that my parents, you know, experiences we had together. But what I have been learning through this experience is like it's a process. And I never know when I'm going to have those feelings. And I wish we would give ourselves more of that grace, especially in relationships, because again, losing someone who you love, who you thought you'd be in a relationship with, I think it's hard because we put time into building these relationships. Then one day someone just says, you know what, I can't do this. Or, you know, the breakup is because of other reasons. And it's just, I think all of those are tough situations for people to deal with.
Yeah, absolutely. And I don't think grief's something you can speed up, right? You've just got to. Actually, in my experience personally, what you're saying, sitting with the pain is the quickest way to speed it up, but it's the most painful because it, for me anyway, if you, like I was numbing, pushing things back, pushing things away, and it just rolled on for years and years. And I'm not saying it wouldn't have anyway, but hang on, let me just turn that off. Sorry.
That's okay.
I'm not saying it wouldn't have anyway, but it really kind of lengthened it out and it didn't hurt anyone except for me, you know?
Yes.
It was still, more painful for me to do that.
All right, because you're just pocketing it. And I think, you know, the best example I could think of is like when you have a bruise, you fall, you hurt yourself, you put a Band-Aid on it, maybe some Neosporin or whatever remedy you use to like make that, you know, that scar or that thing heal and it not scar. But the reality is you lift the Band-Aid too soon, it may not be fully healed. Or if you leave it on too long, then it may, you know, it may heal in a weird way. But the whole point of it is that it's a process of time and it just takes time to really heal. And I think that until you do that, sometimes what happens is you end up repeating similar patterns in relationships. Is so easy because it's just human nature to want to be loved, to want to be in a relationship, to want to feel connected to someone. So it's easy sometimes to not deal with those emotions by either jumping into something else or to just shut down and say, I'm not going to even think about it. I'm going to pretend like everything's okay. And then all of a sudden you're maybe in another relationship or another circumstance in your life. And all those feelings are like, boom. And you're triggered by something so mundane. You're like, where is this coming from? And I think a lot of it's because we keep pocketing down and not really letting ourselves heal, similar to the, you know, the when you bruise yourself, just giving yourself that time.
Yeah, I think that's a really good analogy. That's I used to say that when I was breaking up, I keep ripping the scab off. Like I'm getting there. And then I'm like, oh, let me hurt myself again. I'm just going to rip this scab off and it starts bleeding. And you're like, it was getting there. Like, why?
And then you got to start all over.
I know.